Vinny, a streamer I know got banned, and I think his friends can't even talk about it without getting banned. I saw that there's a streamer that got banned for DMCA related reasons, and then they apparently said that you couldn't, I don't know how true this is, but according to this streamer, he was not allowed to be on his friends' streams. So maybe that's in the contract somewhere. That's a Twitch rule. Imagine that. Banned streamers can't appear on Twitch anymore. Imagine playing a game and then a random song appears. You get a claim for it. And then you can't even... That's it. Persona non grata. Interesting. All right. Well, let's play Minecraft, I guess. So this is not the return of Minecraft in the way that some people would like for it to be. This is the Star Wars pack. I heard it was actually really extensive.
Do it! Do it! Do it! Yes! Unlimited!
So that's me. I am Palpatine. This is the Bedrock Edition, which I'm not really into, but it's whatever it is. Here's some characters from The Mandalorian. Then you have... It's just weird seeing, like, so many pixels. But, yeah, there's Luke.
It was a movie.
Vinny, why don't you get DMCA'd? I have. I have a strike. But yeah, it's really weird. Seeing the extra pixels. That's why I chose old Palpy. Nia Num, Captain Han Solo. Hoth Rebel Soldier. Lando Calrissian. Custom. Where's Lobot? No Lobot. So, yeah, I had to just check this out, because I know it's fun to make fun of Star Wars, and people are sick of it. I still love it. I very much love those first three movies, and this is basically that in Minecraft, so it just felt like it would be a good stream for a little bit. And, yeah, so I think you create new, and then you go down to, God, there's so much stuff that you can buy in this version. It's crazy, and people buy it. I bought it. I bought one. But I did watch someone play a little bit of this, and I was like, wow, this is actually, like, pretty cool. We'll do creative mode. World name, Palpy. Palpy. Simulation distance 12 chunks. Can I turn RTX on for this? Or is that not how this works? Do survival, then creative later. What am I going to do in survival mode in Star Wars? I think it might be a specific thing for RTX. Mine for a lightsaber. This is not online, though. So, I want to see how accurate this is. I want to see the Jizz Whalers in Tatooine. And just explore some of the worlds and take a look. But yeah, it's only on the Bedrock Edition. At least the frame rates are really good. Does this happen every time? I think there's Star Wars music. Should I risk the Star Wars music? I don't know if I should. It's a shame too, because I love John Williams' music so much. Why is it, like, chuggy? Does anyone else see that? Like, I'm moving in increments of chug. It's pre-build. You are using the beta version? What does that mean? Turn off RTX. Does this look RTX to you? Alright, look on the top, it says RTX. That's my card. I don't believe RTX is on, it's just really chuggy. This is not the normal Bedrock version. How do I get the normal Bedrock version? You have to uninstall this one. Cool. Turn off beta via inside Xbox Insider Hub. What the fuck is the Xbox Insider Hub? Why do I have to load multiple applications just to play a game on Windows Store? It's like, Steam isn't, you know, it's only one thing, there's not like multiple things. I can just open the one thing and then update. So I go to settings, manage devices, manage account, about, what am I doing? Chat member, do you know? The Insider Hub does not seem to be doing very much for me. I'm unbelievable. You did this to yourself by signing up to the beta to show it off on stream and not reversing that before now. Yes, of course. Insider content and then Minecraft. I think I had to do this when they... Oh, they did the... That was for the RTX beta when I got this card. Like, NVIDIA told me to do this, I think. Alright, it's pending, so maybe it'll do the thing now. That was the last time you used the Bedrock Edition. Yeah. Well, it's pending. I think it's good now. Does it still say- it still says beta. You have to uninstall the game, then reinstall it. It's really jank. Okay. Add or remove pro. I can't believe Microsoft has come this far in the video game space and still can't, like, figure out updates. Minecraft uninstall. and then reinstall it from the Microsoft Store. Okay, that shouldn't take too long. Install on my devices. I'm so sorry for this, by the way. It's pending. It shouldn't take that long. I think it'll probably be a quick download. Yeah, it just was running really chuggy. I didn't want to play through that while it was that bad. Someone said, interesting, I've always played the Java version. Which one's better? I think the Java version's probably better. But the Bedrock Edition has RTX on. And lots of things you can pay for. Java has mods. It's been proven. I mean, I like it. I just haven't played very much of the Bedrock Edition. I've only played it one time for the RTX, so I don't know as much about it. Bedrock also has cross-play with consoles. There are RTX shaders on Java. Yep, I've used them. And it is installed. But now the aspect ratio is fucked, so... Vinny, you can play music. There's a plugin for OBS that sends the music audio to a different audio line that doesn't record to the VOD. Now, but that also means then that when people watch my my stuff, it still says beta. Why does it still say beta? I'm not using OBS, and then it wouldn't... Unreliable, and you can get banned live. Okay. It still says beta. I turned the beta edition off. You need to uninstall Minecraft and reinstall. I had the same problem. Interesting. Didn't wait for pending. It said it could take 30 to 60 minutes to change. Like 30 minutes, Windows Store fucking sucks. How is this like this? Amazing. I guess all my worlds are gone. So where's my, my worlds that I have? Download. You don't own Bedrock, Microsoft does, and they lease it to you. This is some good troubleshooting stream. So, do I still have my characters? Alright, let's see. It's probably gonna look like shit again, but I have no choice. I'll lower the chunks. I think it's survival. Oh, you can't play that. I can't hear the Imperial March. Nope. Can't hear it. Let me go back. We're gonna do non-creative. That looked like it ran a little bit better, at least. But I need to do, I have to do where I can fly. What is it saving? I moved 2 inches. Love that Bedrock Edition. Absolutely impressive Bedrock Edition. Yeah, this is installed on my SSD. Don't play the beta. Mate, you should have been here a couple minutes ago. Let me guess, uninstall and then reinstall. Creative. There we go. Yeah, again, I had to be in the beta mode back then because that was what I needed for RTX. Alright, well, now we can actually play the thing. This is where Luke gets his blue milk. Or is it green? I forget. What does he drink from the tit? Was that green or blue? I don't remember. The tit was blue, and then what does, Aunt Beru give him? Green tit, blue milk from the bar. Okay, thank you. Got it. So there's a lot of Star Wars-y things here. Don't mind me, chat. I'm just enjoying the menus here. I just really like checking out menus. That said, does anyone know how to go third person in the Bedrock edition of Minecraft Java? Cool. Thanks. It's not chugging too bad anymore. Can I drive this? No, I guess not. R2! Sorry, R2. Oh yeah, no, it's chugging! You're getting 120 frames per second. Maybe I should frame limit. I guess there's no frame limiting. You can get DMCA'd for sound effects. This is the future of streaming. It's just because you're Palpatine and you can't walk around so good. Gonk. Man, it's a shame. I really want to hear this music, too. That's what gives it the Star Wars feel. What's this dude doing with a frog? Huh. That was a pleasure model, Gonk? I hope the fuck not. Where's the cantina? Where's, where Jar Jar stepped in the doo-doo? Imagine just being like a denizen of Tatooine when Palpatine shows up. He's just walking around, show me to the Mos Eisley cantina.
Do it!
I'm looking for the power converters. I don't know where the Tashi station is either. Vinny, that was Mos Espa. Oh, right, you're right. It's like they just keep going back to Tatooine. The whole point of Tatooine was that it was like the worst place in the galaxy. Like, why would anyone go there? And yet, every time, we go back.
Ah yes, Stormtrooper. 5684Z. I wish for you to escort me back to the Death Star. Do it! He didn't do it!
Do you remember that, that line from, what was it, Empire, where they overdubbed Vader? Where he said something perfectly fine and normal, and then George Lucas thought years later to overdub, "Prepare my shuttle!" Yeah, it was just, like, it was like the lamest fucking thing possible. Let me see if I can find it. Vader, bring my shuttle. Okay, no, this is it. So this was the original line. Okay, it was Vader saying, "Bring my shuttle."
Bring my shuttle.
Right? To...
Alert my Star Destroyer to prepare for my arrival.
Like, was that necessary? And it's clearly old James Earl Jones, too. It didn't need to be changed. Bring my shot. Like, he was angry. That was him losing, you know, Luke. Who's this cool dude? This VOD's gonna get fucked. Is that a... What is this? Is this a dewback? Like a bappy dewback? Mute the music? Well, I have the music so low, I thought maybe it might be okay. Listen, if this VOD has to get nuked, then so be it. I hope that muted properly. We'll see. I'm still looking for the cantina. I'm actually kind of surprised at how big Mos Eisley is. Look at this. Oh, Jabba's palace in the distance too. Oh fuck, the Millennium Falcon. It's the Falcon. This came out of nowhere. This is announced with no fanfare whatsoever. And here it is. It's definitely blocky. It is certainly Minecraft. Bum, 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 bum. Bum 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 bum. Mute, mute, mute. VOD mute. DMCA. The DM, the DM, the DMCA too. Bring my shuttle. Hose. Shovels. It's a light shovel. Where's, I need the Star Wars blasters. Horse armor. I need a blaster, dude. Oot. Helmut. There aren't any blasters? I guess there's Chewie's bowcaster. Yeah, okay. That's like one of the two more important things in Star Wars is a blaster and a lightsaber. Oh, here's the chess board table. Hollow chess or whatever the fuck it's called. Yeah, it's... what's it called? It's the thing where Chewie rips off the arms and fucking eats people's arms. Dajic? Yeah, no, it's chess. The hell? I'm on the Death Star now? Tatooine. I don't know where the hell that is. Oh, this is cool. The asteroid field? Bespin? Wow, it really just put me in the middle of a fucking asteroid field. Oh, it's in the cave with the Minox. This is like a very extensive... What the fuck are you doing here? Ah! Ah! I clapped. Clapped so hard. Holy shit. Oh, I see. It's one big map and all of it's kind of... What? Just put together, kind of. There's Hoth. Bespin. Death Star 2. Ice Spider Cave? I don't know if that's in the game. Maybe. I mean, they had Mando armor, but that wasn't an ice cave. Hoth is flat, confirmed. Can't fly a speeder. Spawn some mobs. I mean, this is just exploration mode. I saw an AT-ST. Oh, hello. It's me, the Emperor. Shoot. Shoot the rebels. Maybe, is there a way I can spawn maybe like a rebel or like Luke Skywalker or something? Does anyone know if that's possible? Spawn egg. Spawn pufferfish. Pig. I kind of wish the names weren't just Minecraft. Oh, okay, no, there's Jawas. Jabba the Hutt. Oh, we gotta see Jabba the Hutt soon. Spawn X-Wing? So this is the inside of an AT-AT. I want these stormtroopers to like be like killed by something. Yeah, kill. Kill Wampa. Nice. Awesome. Why is there a stripper pole in this AT-AT? Again, a shocking amount of detail. I'm gonna spawn an X-Wing. I hear Mando music. Can I shoot? Guess not. Whoa, 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 whoa! So crusty.
I have learned to fly an X-Wing, and it has left me scarred and disfigured.
I like the Mando theme song quite a bit. Here's another, like, X-Wing. Like, a real X-Wing. Oh yeah, I'm playing with fire by leaving this music on. God forbid I promote something I like. In an official product that I've purchased. It's a very weird soundtrack, Mandalorian. Like, there's guitars. There's a lot of stuff that John Williams wouldn't use, which I like about it. But yet, you know, there's trumpets, there's orchestra. It's more than vaguely Star Wars, but with some differences, and I really enjoy that about it. It separates itself nicely. It needed... This is, like, exactly what Star Wars needed. I like this part the best, I think. It needed, some new ideas, some new blood. There's the Millennium Falcon again. I don't know what the hell this is doing here. This is in the asteroid field. Oh, there's like multiple Millennium Falcons. You teleport, not the Falcon. I think this might be like the control room in Echo Base. This is if, like, Vader didn't lead the task force, but Palpy did.
Oh!
He could have just, like, used Force Lightning, as we've seen him do on everything. Hello? I mean, this is good RP.
Hello, would you like to RP? I will be Luke Skywalker. You can be Emperor Pipitin, and I will also be Darth Vader. Okay, my Wampa begin to show. It is great dragon. Big, strong. Spit laser.
Man. I mean, it's probably too late now, right? It's like way too late. We went through all of the Mando theme. Just nuke the VOD after the stream, yeah, I will. Nothing in there. Yeah, I could probably, like, stop streaming if I do Proteus tonight. I want to see how much I enjoy this. I might save Proteus. Considering we had some tech problems, and I might do a full Proteus stream instead of like a half Proteus stream. Because, yeah, tech problems means I've only been playing this for 20 minutes, and it's 2:22 already, so... But I do like seeing... all these Star Wars things. I keep wanting to say Lego. It's not Lego. There's no way to, like, move faster, right? Can I use, like, force speed? Double tap W. Thank you. I kept pressing shift. You would think, being like a non-fake Star Wars fan, I could find my way around the cockpit of the Millennium Falcon. Nope. Is this the privy? Find my way to the cockpit is what I meant to say. Do you remember when this whole Millennium Falcon was L3? And it was like, huh? Wait, what? Does L3 watch you piss when you're taking, like, a big laser piss? What an insult. Imagine, like, what they were trying to do with that character, and then imagine, like, being relegated to not being able to talk and being in, like, a janky ship that gets shot at constantly, and then having to watch people piss. Well done. Well done. I'm back at Tatooine because we want to see Java. We want to go to the Java edition. This is where R2 and C-3PO crashed. The escape pod. I don't see any signs of the droids. Where is the Sarlacc pit? Good question. Here. Yep, there's the skiff. Roberta Fettuccini, some would say. Whoa! Yo, that's so fucking weird. What? What the fuck is going on? Ender Dragon. That's good. So I need to go back to Star Wars. Does anyone know how to do that? I can't believe Boba Fett had to fight the Ender Dragon. Why are you not playing on the Java edition? The Star Wars thing is not available for Java edition. I mean, we're not in survival mode. Portal? Yeah, no. Are these supposed to be Endermen? They're just droids. Jump into the void. I tried, remember? I just did that. You can switch to survival in the game menu. Yeah. That's literally how far you can fall, chat. I'm walking along the surface of the bottom of the floor. Yay, that was easy. Echuta. Is it the Razor Crest? Millennium Falcon and Razor Crest parked at the same time, confirmed. I like the Razor Crest is such a piece of shit. It's so cool, and it just gets fucking beat up constantly. The most recent two episodes have, like, utterly destroyed any value that ship may have had. But that's why we love it, because it is so trashy. I feel like something epic is about to happen. Epic! But I'm just going to the cantina for a drink. My clunky! Hey. Jabba, even I get bored sometimes. We know, Harrison. We know. I really thought he was saying, even I get bored sometimes. Like, when I was younger, I didn't know he was saying boarded. And now that I'm older, and I know that Harrison Ford sometimes, like, kind of phones it in. I'm like, yeah, I guess he kind of does get a little bored. Okay, so this cantina is just not here. I'm convinced there's no cantina. It's fake. I was there in VR. I touched their faces. Vinny the Penis Building. I figured a real fan would know. Look, there was a Greedo, a Rodian. This is a McClunky. What's a good starting point for someone who's never seen anything Star Wars? That's easy compared to Star Trek. When people are like, Vinny, what Star Trek should I watch? That's a story. With Star Wars, watch episodes 4, 5, and 6. Or you can be like the cool kids in chat who say, just don't. I understand why you don't like it, because you're just sick of hearing about it. I don't know how you're still watching the stream, this must be painful. But, and then Disney buying it probably didn't help very much. But growing up with these movies, they meant a lot to me. And episode 5 and 4 are still two of my favorite movies ever made. And I know a lot of people who watch them later on in life, who didn't grow up with them, that still enjoyed them. Maybe didn't love them, but still appreciated them as like good sci-fi, fantasy, adventure movies. Someone said it's funny that people still hate the prequels. Well, they're not good movies. They're fun, but, I mean, listen to the dialogue. I don't hate them. I like watching them, but, like, they're not, like, the pinnacle of filmmaking. They're just, like, they're like cartoons, but real life, is the way I describe the prequels. And sadly, they also kind of fucked up Star Wars and divided the fan base. Not as much as now, but for a while, it was really like, wait a minute, what were we watching? But I do appreciate the prequels so much more these days. I really do. And even though those Plinkett reviews are really fun to watch, I still can appreciate watching the movies on their own. Even if I'm, like, kind of holding my head in my hands through half of it, or I can't find the cantina. Oh wait, this is it. I think this is it. Or laughing unintentionally. Yep, this is the cantina. It's empty. Well, all that for that. All right, that's fine. Someone said, I just like Star Trek better than Star Wars. Me too. Yep, I like both. I just like the adventure elements of Star Wars a lot. I love the ships. I love the blasters. I love the music. I remember the way those, the movies made me feel when I first saw them. And they will always have a place in my heart. I will always love the original trilogy. I'll always kind of like the prequels and meme them and quote them. And the sequels are there. And I enjoy Mandalorian. And there's a lot of games that I still really love from the Star Wars franchise. Ha! Nice reference. That's fucking awesome. There's Bib Fortuna. Oh god, that face!
Bib Fortuna. It's me, the Emperor.
It was cool seeing Gamorrean guards fight in the Star Wars Mandalorian.
Sota pip pip poop poo solo.
Droid Disco. How do I play this? Jukebox. Oh yeah, there's the solo in Carbonite. I like how they didn't go with Lego, Minecraft solo, and they just actually, like, just did real solo. What are your favorite Star Wars games? I liked the last year's Jedi Fallen Order. That was good. Not one of my favorites, but I liked it. I love Rogue Squadron. Jedi Outcast. I love Rogue Leader. Like, I have a soft spot for Shadows of the Empire, even though it kind of blows. Like, it's not a fun game to play anymore. It hasn't aged well. But Jedi Outcast, Jedi Academy, Rogue Squadron, Rogue Leader. Battlefront 2, the original, was amazing. Did you play Dark Forces? No, I didn't play Knights of the Old Republic either. I was maybe stubborn, and I liked the Star Wars that told stories from, like, the original trilogy stuff. So I didn't have an Xbox for years. I didn't have a regular Xbox ever. So I didn't have a chance to play Knights of the Old Republic. And I just never did from that point forward. It's on PC. I didn't know it was on PC at the time. Maybe I did, but I just don't know. Like, it's one of those games that people love, and now I have to defend myself for not playing a Star Wars game, which is crazy, but I get it. It's a thing that people love. I guess I just wanted to play in the Star Wars universe that I liked, and I didn't have an Xbox, so I didn't buy it. Maybe my PC wasn't up to snuff at the time. I'm not sure, but I never bought it. I didn't play TIE Fighter. Like, there's a lot of Star Wars games I never played either. I didn't just consume all Star Wars content. There was a Clone Wars game that I liked on the GameCube, and there was Jedi Power Battles on the PS1, which wasn't great, but I still liked it. You already have an X-Wing. So this is Yavin 4. Super Bombad Racing? Yeah, no, I'm good. There was the Pod Racing game, which recently just got re-released on the Switch with 60 FPS and shit, and that's pretty good. Best music right here. This is my favorite Star Wars theme. And, it's the end of Empire. It's so good. Han Solo and the Princess is this theme. It's not Leia's theme. This is Han Solo and the Princess's theme. Even though it sounds like Leia's theme and takes from it a bit. Did you hear they're adding B-Wing and TIE Defender to Squadrons? Yeah, and a new map, too. Kinda cool. I mean, I'm surprised they're supporting it. Palpatine is now taking an X-Wing to the Death Star. It's so stupid. It is so dumb looking. Oh god, what have I done? Han Solo never had a theme of his own until Solo came out 3 years later. Yep, that's true. Han Solo and the Princess was as close as it got, and that was both of their theme. That was their, like, love theme. Isn't Luke's theme just the Force theme? Or does he have his own... I guess his is the, the Star Wars theme in general. Binary Sunset? Yeah, there's a couple different things going on with Luke, but the Binary Sunset, like, that's the Force theme. This is still chugging. Love that beta version. Luke's theme is both Star Wars theme and the Force theme. All right, I'm doing a security check. I want to make sure everyone's working. I, Emperor Palpatine, Emperor Ovaltine. Are you working? Only the best soldiers in the Empire.
Huh?
Damn it. What was Jar Jar's theme? Do you know the fart with reverb? So here's, where Obi-Wan powered down the tractor beam. Why'd they make this so dangerous? I don't understand. Like, why's it gotta be so goddamn dangerous? Cheaper to build without rails. Yeah, the Empire cuts corners when they can. The Empire doesn't exactly seem like a values human life organization, in my unprofessional opinion. Alright, this is where Lobot and Land Solo finally met. Isn't this where C-3PO got shot? People getting wiped out. This is where, this is the room where they held Leia, Solo, and Chewie for a while, right? 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 The Carbonite room. Another Han Solo and Carbonite. I know! What? What do you know? I know! Hey, even I get bored sometimes. Are those clouds? Yeah, looks a little weird, but I'll allow it. Return of the Jedi themes. That's impossible. This is really, really good. I mean, I don't know if I'll ever play this again after today, but I'm enjoying this. Oh, that's the Millennium Falcon again! Cool. Sorry, allergies are happening again. Oh yeah, there's the meat. I was there before on the meat asteroid. Okay, so Death Star 2? Yep, Death Star 2. I like how both Death Stars are here, and including a Skybox Death Star. The Executor. not to scale, not pictured as really is. Nothing here is pictured as the scale it's intended to be, but yeah, this thing is massive. I wonder how, like, when they were making these maps, I wonder if they were like, hey, do we know what the inside of this thing looks like, aside from just that one set? Oh, fuck it, just wing it. I don't even think they tried for- oh, it's Vader's meditation chamber. Huh. There's his helmet! Another meditation chamber? I didn't realize the Executor was just dozens of Vader meditation chambers. I guess he gets angry, he smashes one up, and then he has to go into another, so they just have an infinite supply ready for him. That's Kylo Ren. Oh, you're right. Yeah, Vader didn't throw tantrums because he was a professional. And he was, he was cool, collected, and calm. After the accident, of course. Before that, there's a lot of Kylo Ren. Let's be real. We've seen the prequels.
Well, I hate you!
It's just when he got old and he was in the suit, he was just like, oh, whatever. Like, there's a scene where I think Luke gets away and he's just like, he just looks. He just looks. Or like, no, when at the end of Empire, when the Falcon jumps to hyperspace. There's just a close-up of Vader's helmet, and he just looks out the window, and he walks a little bit. And that's it. He doesn't, like, smash his helmet into a wall. The hell? Oh, where's the bridge? Oh, I think it's here. This is a very important scene. I quote this scene all the time. I see you have constructed a new lightsaber. Ah! Or it might be this. It's one of these bridges. Dork vapor. It's kind of funny, when I was a kid, when the only Star Wars content we have was the, you know, Return of the Jedi, Empire Strikes Back, and A New Hope. And Return of the Jedi, everyone made fun of because the Ewoks, they were annoying. And now I look back at the Ewoks and I'm like, fuck yeah, yub-nub. 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 But at the time, they were just like, kind of a little lame. Now it's like, yub-nub. Yub-nub. I think they still are just like a weird missed opportunity, like... I think they were supposed to do, a Wookiee planet instead of Ewok planet. Bow and arrow here? What the fuck? I broke the switch. I clapped. I think George Lucas is very on the nose with his naming of things. Endor being the end of the trilogy. Darth Vader father, Palpatine heart palpitations, Elon Sleazebagano, you know, because he's maybe not the most nicest of people. Darth Icky, as we all know, was a potential that never happened. Insidious. Mon Calamari. Squid creatures. I was going to say creepers, but that too. Yeah, well, I named this music Jizz because it's just that good. That was an accident. I don't think George Lucas actually knew what the word jizz meant. But then again, I did read that there was someone who asked their teacher because they saw the jizzed in your pants thing. This is I read on the internet, on the funny internet. They saw the jizzed in your pants music video and they thought that that was just another word for pee. So they asked their teacher if they could go to the toilet because they needed to take a jizz. So imagine that. That's got to be one of those things that you just never forget the rest of your life. Is it true? I don't know if that's true. I have no idea. I can't confirm that. That's internet stories. You know how that is. Sounds like a made-up internet story, but think about how many internet points it got. Think about it. Could have bought a fucking Ferrari with that much points. Where do they look out of at the end of Empire? The medical frigate. What is this doing in here? You need to go. Back towards the engines. Oh, by the way, both Vinesauce World of Horror mod packs are complete for now, I think. Complete. So that's going to be a cool future stream. Maybe sometime this week or the end of the week. So this might be Mandalorian stuff. This isn't where the crate dragon was, right? Oh, it's chapter one. Oh, okay, yeah, I remember this. The first quest. I need to rewatch that at some point. Go through all of the first season. I mean, I guess it kind of makes sense in some ways that they would do the most recent Star Wars content with the oldest Star Wars content, especially because it has a similar feel. But I wouldn't have been opposed to, like, Mos Espa showing up and having some of the pod race stuff. I want to see Ben Quadrinos. Again, Tatooine is all across the prequels, so they could have easily incorporated some prequel stuff. Just had, like, an extension of Tatooine. Oh, there's the Razor Crest. The Razor Crest is my favorite. What do you think Bill Burr will be a recurring Star Wars character? I think Space Boston will be revealed at some point. We will go to his home. Flossed in Paradise. Also, it's way too late for Proteus, and I want to give that a proper stream. So I'm going to play this for like another half hour and just explore. Proteus, I'll probably do tomorrow. So what's this? I don't know what this is. Prison ship from Mando. Oh, this is the Bill Burr episode. I think this also just goes to Mando locations, where the Millennium Falcon goes to the trilogy locations. What was the mod you said earlier? What? Oh, World of Horror. I'm sorry. I thought you meant for Minecraft. What's that noise? The child here? I like how everyone just agreed that its name is Baby Yoda. Like, immediately. Like, there's no other name for the thing. How could it be anything else? But all the official advertising for the product that is now Baby Yoda, which, by the way, they know they had a gold mine on their hands. That was like a product that they could package and sell. No one wants Poe Dameron. They all want Baby Yoda. But yeah, it's all the child. And it's everywhere. Like sand. Baby Yodas are very... They, like, pumped out the merch for that thing. Yeah, I heard, like, something. It's a freaking stormtrooper. Dig your way out of every spaceship. Yaddler on the roof? What? I like how the world is disgusted by the thought of Palpatine boning, myself included. But when people discuss how Baby Yoda came to be, it's like, well, yeah, Yoda and Yaddle probably, you know, yaddled. And that's fine. Well, no one complains about it. Chat's complaining about it now, but... Huh. Okay, I'm gonna need a reminder because I don't remember what episode this was. Is this the last episode? Oh, this is the one where the Taika Waititi droid was, in the lava river. I remember now, okay. This is the planet Mando was on Navarro. It had the Bounty Hunters Guild. Yep, confirmed. I need to rewatch the season one of Mandalorian because I don't remember it. Not like I need to. I mean, I've already impressed everybody so much with my knowledge of Star Wars. My knowledge is going to get me so many new fans. And I'm going to be real popular and desirable. You know, very desirable. Because if you want to be desirable in this planet, you have to play Minecraft Star Wars and be like a tour guide and go to each location and check out the ships and name them accurately.
Yeah.
You've impressed me, but I'm also a Star Wars nerd. Well, the thing is, I'm not really getting too many deep cuts here. I don't think anything about this is particularly impressive, but... I mean, look, it's Jabba the Hutt and Salacious Crumb. We all know the names of Salacious Crumb and Jabba the Hutt. Okay, maybe not everyone knows about Salacious Crumb, but... That's what, you know... That's where years of lore... And behind-the-scenes footage. In fact, I took a nap earlier because I was feeling real funky because the weather changed so drastically today. And, my autoplay on YouTube was, like, just Star Wars making of. And I was watching... Like, excuse me, behind-the-scenes. And I realized that... You see, now I'm yawning because I said nap. And I watched the behind-the-scenes stuff, and I was like, oh, I've seen most of this. At some point in my life or another, I've seen, like, all the documentaries that I could get my hands on. And then it went, autoplay took it to Blade Runner, of course, which I'm also okay with. And Trumbull was also, the Douglas Trumbull, who did the practical effects, I don't remember if he did miniatures or not, but he was also on Blade Runner. So I'm fascinated by how these movies are made, just as much as I enjoy the movies. I love the sets. I love the lore of the creation of the movies and how many things went wrong during filming. Alright, now I can finally show you the secret of Yoda's hut. Where is it? Where's the secret? It's not here. Fuck! There it is. There's the secret. You saw it. Why are there stormtroopers on Dagobah? Troopers. The idea of Yoda's hut being his escape pod from episode 3, and then he built a hut around that. That's really all there is to that. The secret of Yoda's hut. The stormtroopers are just reskinned zombies. Oh yeah, I guess you're right. Which, if you consider stormtrooper aim, that's about right. Here it is. Here I am. Wait, what? Why are there two Palpatines? Who's the real Palpatine? Oh, it's the... This makes too much sense. This explains the sequel trilogy. Or just the one sequel. Why is this Palpy on fire? Copyrighted laugh. So, not only is this Palpy burning, but is hovering in electricity. Okay. Which one's the clone? I have this Lego set. When I was a little addicted to Lego this year, chat. I have the throne room Lego set. Nice clouds. You can disable the clouds. Why is Sheev so milky though? I want to know what's up with that. That was easy. Galaxy saved. Oh, okay. So this is what happened. Okay, so listen. Palpy got pulpied. Right? Fall down the pit. Fall and fall and fall. And then... Here's the core. That was destroyed. And then so too was Palpatine. And while that happened, I, representing the clone of Palpatine, or the original version, I'm not sure, I've lost track, escaped. Just like this. Just like this. Wait, what? How do you get out of here? Oh, there, just like this. Fuck. Listen, if they're gonna reveal sequel lore in Fortnite, I can reveal Palpatine lore in Minecraft. And you know what? Sure, it's a Minecraft DLC pack, but it makes a whole lot more sense. I like how, you can tell, like, someone who's like a fucking mega nerd or multiple mega nerds made this. Because every detail is replicated to the best of their ability. Including the, you know, like you press the button, it opens up the little cargo hatches. Java. Even I get bored sometimes. These are people who are probably paid to be mega nerds. Yep. Well, I mean, you gotta imagine there's probably people on the team who are like me that grew up with these movies and watched them over and over and over again and just know this stuff inside and out, like, way better than I do. Remember, I didn't have Fortnite growing up, chat. So the best I had was a couple video games a year and my worn out Star Wars VHS tapes. That was the way I could transport to another world. That, and I had a couple friends too, but we were all nerds. So we would just talk about Star Wars, which is one of those things that also got me in trouble because there were a lot of kids in class that hated Star Wars, even at the time. So it wasn't exactly good for my social life, but eventually it evened out and no one really cared in the end. Like when cool video games for Star Wars were talked about, no one really cared anymore. It was just like, oh, that's a cool video game. Hey, I want to watch that Star Wars stuff. It seems cool. Can you pilot the Millennium Falcon? No, you can only use it to go to hyperspace and warp to different areas. But yeah, this is cool. It's a little limited in the fact that, like, there's not really an adventure. Well, maybe there is. I mean, I guess the survival mode is still survival mode. You can get your own baby Yoda. How? Is it a chicken? Whoa, fuck that! Oh, Bantha. Oh yeah, I can't milk that, I'm sorry. You have to go to the laser. It not a spawn egg. You have to go to the laser. Use Mando's ship to travel where he found it and feed it rabbit stew. Alright, that's the last thing I want to do tonight on the stream, is I want to find the child. The baby Yoda. Just need to get to Mando's cockpit. Where's this damn thing? I don't know the layout of the ship. Up. Here it is. Okay, so that appears to be the spot. So we were here earlier, but now we can go on the adventure. I don't remember the first episode. Wasn't it in, like, one of these buildings? Big blast door area. It was, like, here. Oh, okay, now I kind of do remember. This is the laser. Right! Right, right, right! Give the child rabbit stew to earn their trust. Okay, so rabbit stew. We gotta find some rabbit stew. You do realize I'm the emperor, right? Classic Palpy.
Do it!
I will adopt you and I will raise you into the most powerful force user that the galaxy has seen.
This is the good ending. This is the way. Where Emperor Palpatine and Baby Yoda leave and control the galaxy together. It'll take a couple hundred years before Baby Yoda grows up, I think, but when he does, Palpatine will have his most powerful ally yet.
Evil.
Look at my face crust. Look at my milky face crust. Would I lie to you?
Hang on a second. These fucking noises. The fuck? Is that the child that...
Come, Baby Yoda. I will raise you correctly. Have you ever played Bookworm Adventures?
I'm going full DMCA. Fuck it. I'm not, though. Wait, did his mouth just open or close? Just... really wasn't worth the gag. But, alright, well, that's fine then. That was good. That was surprisingly, like, I guess just a lot of work was put into that. And I haven't played one of those Minecraft packs before, but it's okay. I enjoyed seeing people's takes on all the Star Wars locations. It's very, very fan service-y, which of course is what you can expect from something like this. But I enjoyed it, and I always enjoy talking about classic Star Wars. So, that was fun. Proteus I'll probably just stream tomorrow, like I said. And, haven't decided on more bug snacks, but I did get a couple, like, full essays. Multiple paragraph essays. And yes, don't worry, I'll be nuking the VOD. So, anyway, thank you for watching the stream. Let's do the art. Okay, so where were we? Okay, so starting with this from Binky. So here's an AI that has been, popular. It's been recommended a bunch. And I'm definitely planning on checking this AI out. So I don't know what I'll be pairing it with, because I don't think I can get a whole stream out of just this one AI, but I think there's a couple other AIs that I haven't checked out yet, so this will be fun. But yeah, you get to draw, like, animals, and they become real animals, but it's weird. So thank you, Binky. Here's one from Captain Marchy.
Meat dog.
Meat dog. Meat dog.
Excellent. Fucking Pikmin music is so weird. But great work. Here's one from Nora. Here's a BRB. I like that. That's me and some coffee. Or actually hot chocolate, which I had today. Yeah, this is straight up Pikmin 2 music. But hey, cool art, really well done, nicely detailed, interesting concept. Here's one from Phoenix Seraph.
Oh yeah, I cooked two ladies. I definitely mean A-dub, I cook reasonably well.
Oh my god. Oh, V-dub lore! Wait, what's going on under the V-dub hat? Oh shit, is this real? Is V-dub real? Oh no. Fuck you, V-dub. No, this is pretty good. I like the alien sitting with the fuck- with the, bib. I couldn't think of the word for bib. But hey, this is really good. Thank you, Phoenix Seraph. Okay, so here's one from Cheesy Draws. It's a YouTube video. I'm gonna download it. So I'll be honest, I think I know what this is gonna be. But let's take a look. I have a feeling. But I haven't seen it yet, so I don't know. I don't know. Yep, it's me! That's pretty great. So, looking for them preaching to the choir moments here, but Chrono Trigger music. Extra animations. I saw the Scoot Birds. Corrupted Bombs, like in the original Spelunky mod. Very nice. New item textures. I even got a journal entry? New enemy textures. Extra dialogue. Yeah, it's true. I like the vine shroom. Yeah, it definitely harkens back to the days of the original Spelunky mod, but it looks really good. The vine whip is back. Someone's getting pulped in Spelunky. Trying to record this footage. Your character art had a reverse hand. That sounds about right. But yeah, this is... oh, God. Some fucking gruesome deaths. Really, really, really nice work, though. Yeah, it fits the style, like, perfectly. So I might have to download that at some point. I don't know if I can still get achievements. Maybe? Maybe someone else would know? You can. Well, not even achievements, but, like, unlock stuff in the game. Like, it's still the game, I'd imagine. But really good art, really good work on that. I will have to install that. And then I can be the height of narcissism and play as myself in a video game, as I've done before. But nice work. This one's from Umania. Doodle Dip, in the style of, like, old, I guess, Disney. Right? Like, Oswald? Pretty cool. Pre-Disney. Like, rubber hose animation era. Oh, okay, okay. Well, that is... a unique doodle dip. I like it. Gongalicious made this. Wow. Wow. I like the 1-1 snake, but this art is great. Cat Pog, Least Project, and Rafi. I mean, it's just, the art is so good, so detailed. And I always appreciate Spelunky art. Yep. Great work. Here's one from Uberon. And here's a I did some concept art when I noticed it vaguely resembled a shroom. Made me want to do a Vinesauce variation of it. Kind of looks like a Vinesauce UFO. Pretty cool. Looking up all the little details, the greebles, as they're called. Yeah, very much like this. Earthlead in 64 made some art vine snacks. Also really cool. Done traditionally as well. Like the logo. Good, good. Waylon Valen made a more Bugsnax stuff. It's the thing. It's the thing, but Bugsnax. There's some sweat frog right there for you. But, pretty cool. So this next art is gonna ruin Kit Kats for me forever. Merper Hour made the house catipede. We were talking about, what would my bug snack be? And it would be something Kit Kat related maybe because I like them, but oh, this is really bad. I mean, the art is fucking phenomenal, like the realism of the textbook art is great, but I absolutely do not want to eat a Kit Kat ever again. Jesus. Well, thank you for that, and the nightmares. This one's from Galdap Jr., and it's World of Sauce. It says, now that the World of Sauce mod is done and posted, I decided to make a logo for it. The logo is made to look like the game's normal logo has been modified. Cool. And it's sauces from left to right. Spaghetti, aioli, unknown, cocktail, eggusi, juicy. I don't know what that is, that last one, but yeah, this is really great. Looking forward to playing it. I don't know when that time will come, but I'll play both mods. CEO Vinny stunks, smokes fat stogie whenever he wants. Stogie. All chat is now paid members, never loses Smash ever. Giant David Byrne sized suit. 10 gallon hat Ryzen. Yeah, chat, I just bought out all of Better Twitch TV. I think Twitch itself might be next. Media mogul Vinesauce. Yeah, sure. That's fucking funny. Alright, well, I like this, and I appreciate the art tonight. I think that's all of it. This was fun. Sorry for the technical problems earlier. These things do happen. But I'd like to, stream more soon. Tomorrow I'll be streaming. I don't know what I'm streaming yet, aside from Proteus, but I've got a lot of stuff to stream, and Hyrule Warriors is out, and it's getting reviews between, like, sixes and nines. So it's gonna be one of those things. Where people are saying, it depends on how much you like Musou stuff. So... yeah. We'll see. I like the original Hyrule Warriors enough that I think I'll enjoy it. But I know it'll have some of those issues that I had with the demo. But regardless, I'll be streaming it. And thank you again, everybody, for watching. And I'll catch you tomorrow. Good night. If you want to watch some other streamers, you can go to twitch.tv/team/vinesauce, vinesauce.com. And wait here for auto-host, and it'll take you to all my streamer friends. You might enjoy. Good night. See you tomorrow. Bye.